For some time, I've experimented with using my Android tablet as a second monitor for my main Windows laptop. The first app I used was Space Desk. It was fairly easy to set up. It supported touch, but it used a wireless connection, and to no surprise, it was laggy. It's still a good app though, and I do recommend it to Windows users. The second app I used is Super Display. I tried it a couple of times and was blown away of how smooth it was for multitasking. I used it at school, of course, and it did lag, but it was mostly good because it used a Type-C charger to do it on. Unfortunately though, it didn't last forever because it has a 3-day free trial that costs $10 or $15 according to the app or their Google Play Store. But Windows and long intro aside, I used this laptop connected to this TV as a second monitor, and it's already so good anyway. For school, however, I use this hand-me-down laptop with decent specs, which is why I use Linux on it, specifically Pop! OS, my new daily driver. Now since this is a Linux system, I obviously can't download Space Desk or Super Display because they are for Windows. I could get an actual portable monitor and plug it into my crappy laptop, but I'm not into those, and 15.6 inches is too big. It's basically a whole laptop. I have no space left. I have found two alternative applications called Deskreen and Weylus though, but both of them use a wireless connection, so of course they will be slow. For Deskreen, go to the official website, scroll down, and click on the .deb or .appimage file. After it's installed, open the app. It will tell you to change your language or theme. All that good stuff. Alright, so here you can see there's a QR code you can click to make it bigger. And of course, with QR codes, you can scan it. So let me just scan this. There we go. Alright, so it will both pop up like this. So my device info is this. It's correct, so let me allow it on the computer. Now, you can share the app window, or you can just share the entire screen. I'll share my entire screen. Why not? My entire screen. And confirm. And in just a few seconds, it will do this. Now, I'll just click on the gear icon up here. I can flip the video, which I don't know why anyone would do that, but I'll just put this to auto just to get, I guess, a bit better performance. But as you can see here, it literally just duplicates my screen. So yeah, it's like showing the same thing on my tablet. Yeah. To fix this, the creator of Deskreen encourages you to get a HDMI dummy plug, which he does display on his website. I got mine for $7 and it came in this kind of packaging for some reason. But hey, at least I have a HDMI dummy plug now. Alright boys, HDMI dummy plug. Let me plug in there right there. Yeah. Alright, I scan the QR code and allow entire screen. And now it should say screen 2. This is a screen created by the HDMI dummy plug. So confirm, and it should pop like this. Let me make it auto again, and look at this. Okay, it's the other way around. Let me do something really basic here. Let me just change my display settings. Oh, look at that. Look how laggy that is, bro. How are you supposed to do work like this? So what's happening here is like it's using your second monitor to duplicate it to your tablet to make it look like you have a second monitor, which is actually pretty genius, but it's pretty laggy, as you can see. Yeah. Alright, I'm 25%. Alright, the lowest graphic setting, so okay, yeah, I guess that's good. It's okay, but it's not good in performance. Like, you can't play video games or like do actual really fast tasks. Or you can't use your USB charger to like plug it onto your computer like Super Display. So you can't really do that. Kinda sad. One of the problems with scanning the QR code a bunch of times here, as you can see, it makes a bunch of tabs, and you can just delete all of them at once, but this is pretty annoying, to be honest. It definitely is a problem that could be fixed, you know. I have used my main laptop with 16GB of RAM and an iPad on a whole other network, and it was a little bit bearable than what this is. It's still laggy though. I have used Deskreen to game at some point, which was okay, but don't expect miracles. If you just want to play PC games on your phone, just use Parsec or Shadow. Gigabit Ethernet or LAN network didn't do much. It was just still laggy, even on good enough hardware. So it's either just the tablet or the Wi-Fi. Weylus is another alternative that I talked about, and unlike Deskreen, this actually lets you use your tablet as a graphic tablet / touchscreen for your computer. And it also has hardware acceleration, so that's pretty nice. On the right side, click on the releases and click on the .deb file. After that's installed, open the app of course. One of the first things I did in Weylus was enter the access code, and this is basically just a password. You can enter out anything, but no, this is optional. You don't have to enter a password. You can if you want, but honestly, it doesn't matter. So, off this bind address port, WebSocket port, I'll leave off this by default. Weyland pipewire support. I don't know what this is, but it does say this may crash your desktop, so I'm not gonna check that. Hardware acceleration, a video acceleration API. I guess I'll turn that on. This is just NVIDIA, so yeah. Now all I gotta do is press start and start. And of course, like the screen, you have to scan the QR code and it will open up in the browser. Okay, so it says fail to create U input device. Now, I don't know what all this means, but I do have a fix for it. Press OK, X. Go down here to input and just uncheck enable U input. Just uncheck it. And it should do this. Monitor EDP, I think. Yeah, monitor EDP saves the day, guys. If you see your like screen look like this, it's stretched out, just uncheck stretch video. It should. But yeah, it duplicates your display just like that screen. You can change it by changing the options on the capture. Monitor HDMI, press that. And there you go. There is your second monitor or second screen right there. If your video is laggy, you can just turn down the video resolution and it should do the trick. Maybe. Okay, yeah, that's fine. That's fine. I can guess I can deal with that, but it's not good for seeing because it's so pixelated. For touching, it's decent. It is still pretty laggy, so If you want to do like graphic design stuff, just duplicate it. If I had like a good tablet and a good computer and a good Wi-Fi connection and a lot of money, the experience would be pretty good, but honestly it's not. Kid becomes a grown-up for 24 hours, darn man. Oh, I forgot about the sound.
Jay, are you okay in there?
This is really unplayable. You can't watch YouTube videos like this. I'm not joking. And the audio, it doesn't go to the tablet. Does it? Oh, there's HDMI DisplayPort built-in audio here. Let me just. It just plays on the computer all the way. I used my main laptop and gigabit Ethernet to test this out again. Since this is Windows, it connects to your tablet a little bit differently and quite harder to get a good grasp of. In terms of performance, it sucks, but I did manage to draw something in GIMP. Pretty neat to show off to your friends, don't you think? As for a second monitor, I couldn't get it to work, but who cares? I could just use all these apps. Although this isn't free, it's still cool to use your Android tablet as a second monitor or screen in Linux. Now, you might not experience this, so this is just your mileage may vary situation. But still, Deskreen and Weylus are pretty good applications, and I recommend you guys check them out. In the future, I hope it improves by using a USB Type-C charger to connect your tablet and PC together, or maybe even an app. But yeah, I think that's all I need to say in this video. I hope you guys are having a great Christmas day, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.